Good morning, everyone, and welcome to St. Elizabeth Ann Seaton Parish for a celebration of the 32nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. As we enter into worship, let's sing hymn number 712, The King of Love My Shepherd Is, number 712. Singing Psalm 63 today, My Soul is Thirsting for You. It's number 1185 in the hymnal. Please sing it after me now. Please stand now and welcome each other by name to this celebration. Thank you.
our crisis of judgment, for gain or for loss.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Good morning, everyone, and welcome as we gather on this beautiful morning to offer our praise and thanks to God. A welcome especially to our visitors, anyone who might be with us for the first time. Let us now ask the Lord to rid us not just of our distractions, but also our sin.
Lord, you are the wisdom, the prudence, and guidance of our life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, you are our glorious hope in the face of death. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, you are the lamp that is the light of our undimming love. Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King. God Almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Lord Jesus
Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. We pray through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. I invite all those young people who wish to go apart for the liturgy of the word to come up. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, good morning. Nice crowd today. All right. Love the smiles. A All right, let me say a prayer blessing for you. Stay right there. Lord God, we ask that you send your Holy Spirit upon these, your and our children. Open their ears, their minds, their hearts, that they might hear your holy word and live it in peace. Go in the peace of Christ. Let it shine.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Resplendent and unfading is wisdom, and she is readily perceived by those who love her, and found by those who seek her. She hastens to make herself known in anticipation of their desire. Whoever watches for her at dawn shall not be disappointed, for he shall find her sitting by his gate. For taking thought of wisdom is the perfection of prudence, and whoever for her sake keeps vigil shall quickly be free from care, because she makes her own rounds, seeking those worthy of her, and graciously appears to them in the ways and meets them with all solicitude. The word of the Lord.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. O God, you are my God. At dawn I seek you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Be your mind, heart, and on your lips, that you worthy proclaim the holy gospel of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them. But the wise brought flasks of oil for their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight there was a cry, "Behold, the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those virgins took up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the doors were locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. So as the lights lengthen, and fall fades into winter, the church this month in the Mass readings are reminding us that one day Jesus will come and conclude and bring to a conclusion, rather, human history. One day this world will end. Today's gospel is a reminder of that lesson in our faith. The setting for the gospel today is the Jerusalem temple. Jesus is just a few days away from his execution. He has been locked in argument with his enemies, the Pharisees, the scribes. And now he turns his attention to a very stark reality. He says to his disciples, "The day will come when all this will be gone. The magnificent temple, the city of Jerusalem, life and the world as we know it. And when it does, we need to be ready to meet God." Today, Jesus preaches a parable about that, the parable of the 10 bridesmaids who went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 were wise, 5 were foolish. The wise one brought extra oil. The 5 foolish ones did not. And sure enough, the bridegroom was late. Now that's different. It's usually the bride that's late. But the bridegroom was delayed and came at midnight. And when the bridesmaids awakened, the 5 with the oil were able to get into the wedding feast. The 5 foolish were locked out because they had to go into town and buy oil. When they came back, the door was locked. They knocked on the door and the bridegroom said, "I don't know you." Then Jesus says, "Therefore, stay awake. You know neither the day nor the hour." I think Jesus is making 2 points for us to ponder today. First of all, life as we know it, this world, will end one day. Jesus will come back at the end of history, and when he does, he will judge us. And if we're not alive for that, we one day will close our eyes for the final time in this life, and we will enter into eternity. We don't know when or how that will happen, but it will. The second challenge, or rather the second point is, that we as disciples are called to be vigilant, prepared. Jesus will come when we least expect it, and when he does, we are to be ready, because we will be held account of our lives. So the 2 challenges of the gospel today comes off of those 2 points. The first of all is to recognize our mortality. This world, our lives in this world will end one day. This gospel message not meant to scare us, but it's a reality check, because we get so engrossed in the things of this world, we get so caught up in its pace, that we forget this is not all there is. Thank God. Life has its challenges, and life is wonderful, especially as we experience the love of family and friends. That one day God is going to call us home to himself. That's why he made us, to live with him forever in heaven. And we should never forget that. We should never forget that. And the second challenge is to be ready. Be prepared. Be vigilant. We don't know the hour or the day. And our readiness to embrace, or rather our readiness is going to be measured by our willingness to embrace the wisdom of God's word and let that wisdom shape our lives. That's the oil we are called to have in the gospel today, the wisdom of God's word, and to live that wisdom, live that word. Be patient and kind. The wisdom of peace and reconciliation, the wisdom of compassion and charity, the wisdom that allows us to see God in every human person and give them the dignity and respect they deserve. The best way that we can be prepared to meet Jesus at the end of our lives in this world is to recognize him in the flesh of one another. to recognize him, care for him in the needs of others. And so, my friends, as we gather at the Lord's table this day, as we are called to be vigilant and prepared, let us pray that as we dine on the very body and blood of Christ, let us pray for the oil of God's holy wisdom, that that oil, that wisdom will shape our lives, the lamp of our lives, so that one day, whenever happens, we will be ready for the wedding feast of heaven. Let us stand and profess together our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scripture. Seated at the right hand of the Father, he will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, and who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As we ready our hearts to receive Jesus in the Eucharist, let us bring our prayers to the Lord.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For the Church, that our belief in the hope and promise of eternal life may help us to serve God more faithfully, let us pray.
Lord,
for peace in our world, that hearts may be transformed so that there may be an end to war and violence throughout the world. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all newly elected officials, that they may fulfill their duties with integrity and work tirelessly to address the crucial issues of our society. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For veterans and their families, that the Lord will preserve them from all harm, bless them with peace, and give them strength during challenging times. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the children baptized at our parish this weekend, that they may grow into disciples of the Lord through the help of their parents, godparents, and our parish community. Let us pray. For John Walker, whom we remember especially at this Mass, for the seriously ill or hospitalized, including John Hill, Earl Amy, Pat Cullen, Francis Bullard, Jack Coolidge, and Olivia Rose Marie Cheney, and for the faithful departed in our parish book of remembrance, and all those who have recently died, including Andrea Barrett Graves, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the needs of our sister parishes in Haiti and Baltimore, the intentions written in our Book of Intercessions, and for what or for whom do we pray today?
Lord,
hear our prayer.
Seeking the intercession of Our Lady for peace. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And we pray all these things through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, sir.
Our preparation hymn is number 581. O God, you search me. Number 581. Thank you. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Lord, look with favor upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion. We pray through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Out of compassion for our sinful ways, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin Mary. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, gave us eternal life. And so with all the choirs of angels and saints,
May our voices be one in grateful praise as we sing. Lord, you are holy indeed, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. And humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her husband, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look then not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
God's peace. Thank you, Michael. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you. heard what God has ready for those who love Him. Spirit of God,
come us the word of Jesus, which has the wisdom of
God. Here are today's announcements. With only a week left until delivery of the Thanksgiving meals, we still need 246 more dinners to make our promised goal. Dinners can be dropped off after Masses this Sunday or on Monday and Wednesday next week. Christmas outreach begins this weekend. Representatives for each program will be in the narthex to answer questions and to sign you up to donate or volunteer. The Children's Choir is preparing to provide music for Santa's visit to the Crofton Country Club on November 29th and the pageant on Christmas Eve. Children who are not in the choir are welcome to participate. Rehearsals are Wednesdays at 4:30. Breakfast with Santa is Sunday, December 10th. Tickets go on sale next weekend. Please continue to add names of your deceased loved ones to the Book of Remembrance and place framed photos of them on the table beside it. Poor Box contributions this week benefit Haiti Outreach. The Sacrament of the Anointing of the Sick will be available after Mass. Today is Donut Sunday. Everyone is invited down to the Parish Center after Mass.
Let us pray. Lord, nourished by this sacred gift, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered. We pray through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray for vocations. Loving and generous God, it is you who call us by name and ask us to follow you. Help us to grow in the love and service of our church as we experience it today. Give us the energy and courage of your Spirit to shape its future. Grant us faith-filled leaders who embrace Christ's mission of love and justice. Bless the parish of St. Elizabeth Ann Seaton by raising up dedicated and generous leaders from our families and friends who will serve your people as sisters, priests, brothers, deacons, and lay ministers. Inspire us to know you better. Open our hearts to hear your call. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Again, thank you for being here today. It's always, always a privilege and a pleasure to lead you in the celebration of Mass. As you do your grocery shopping this week, please remember to pack a bag for our Thanksgiving food drive. We're running a little bit ahead. And also, again, another shout out to our young families. Thank you for being here today. Always, always a pleasure to hear the noise of the young ones. We have 9 baptisms this Sunday. So that's a sign of God's blessing to us. So let us pray for our families as they raise their children in the ways of faith. My friends, the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace. Glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
As we go out today, remembering to be vigilant and be prepared, we sing our recessional hymn, number 871. We shall rise again, number 871.
Thank you. Hallelujah.